can't even enjoy what God has for you. But I meet a lot of people that think that. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know that everybody does.
Yeah, because he just got out of the slap. So he's all bedaubed with dirt and mud. Before then, what was he wearing anyway? Rags. And he had this burden on his back. And yet the people of the city of destruction counted him as well-dressed. And the burden, I mean, he's bent over, but they counted him as an upstanding citizen. They had no idea, why are you doing this? And so the worldly wise man comes along and says, oh yeah, here's what you need to do. Go to this place where you will get cleaned up outwardly. Essentially, that's what his advice is. And there are so many, as we said, so many people who really feel like, I will come to Christ after. Fill in the blank. For young people, after I sow my wild oats. The older you get, after I've raised my family, or after I've done well in business, or after this, or after that, I will do this. I think after is the devil's word. And that's what we really see happening in Christian's life. In the middle of 18, Christian turned out of his way to go to Mr. Legality's house for help. But behold, when he was gotten down hard by the hill, it seemed so high, and also that side of it that was next the wayside did hang so much over that Christian was afraid to venture further lest the hill should fall on his head. Wherefore there he stood still and wanted not what to do. This falling on the head. One of the things that Bunyan liked to do is he loved tintinnabulation. You know that? It's the sound of the bells. Sound of bells. And so one of the things that he describes as one of his favorite sins was to ring the enjoy ringing the church bells. We would go, why is that a sin? But in his unconverted state, he began to consider what might happen to him if one of the bells would spring loose from its moorings while he was ringing. And it would fall on his head. He would die. This is the type of thing that Bunyan worried about. And so when he's writing about climbing this hill, this is actually one of my great nightmares, recurring nightmares, of not climbing but being in a vehicle that trying to go up a hill and it becomes steeper and steeper and steeper until finally, boom, you fly backwards instead of up it. And then you wake up. But he has this great burden, and he's going up the hill, ventures further, lest the hill should fall on his head. Wherefore there he stood still and wotted not what to do. Also his burden now seemed heavier to him than while he was in his way. There came also flashes of fire out of the hill that made Christian afraid that he should be burned. What's that a reference to? Mount Sinai. Remember when Moses is on Sinai? There's flashes of fire, thunder. This is the law. This is what... Do not touch the mountain. Don't get near the mountain. You will surely die. It's the word of utter destruction for those who cannot keep it. There are came flashes of fire out the hill that made Christian afraid he should be burned. Here, therefore, he sweat and did quit for fear. And now Bunyan gives his first little poem within. His poems are not always great, but they're always instructive. When Christians unto carnal men get ear, out of their way they go and pay for it dear. For master worldly wise men can but show a saint the way to bondage and to woe. Someone comes along and it's evangelist who rebukes Christian for not being on the path anymore and warns him of the danger that awaited him as he's going to morality. And so he gets back on the true path. And Christian makes his way further on toward the wicked gate. And as he approaches the gate, he comes within range of arrows, doesn't he? The arrows are coming from where? The Beelzebub's it's helpful to remember that that's what Satan's always going to be doing. He's going to be firing those fiery darts at us. Couple of things I want to say before we get in, before we leave this place, and that's what Evangelist has to say about worldly wise men. If you're looking at page 20, he gives three things about worldly wise men. Number one, he turns thee out of the way. Two, his laboring to render the cross odious to thee, meaning not good. Three, is setting thy feet in that way that leadeth unto the administration of death. Bunyan is laying it on the English clergy at this point. He's not just saying they're wrong. He's saying they will lead you to hell. That message of morality apart from Christ, of legality and obedience apart from the cross, is going to lead you into a moral lifestyle, perhaps, but one that is completely opposed to biblical Christianity, completely opposed to the cross. Bunyan knows, and I would like to share a little bit more about Bunyan's purpose in writing this. He's writing about the Christian, not just about the Christian life, but there's some deep doctrine here that's going on. If you're willing to look into it. So Evangelist tells him what to do. Go to the gate. He gets on the path. He's within the range of these arrows, and then he finally comes to the gate where Goodwill pulls Christian through the gate to safety. But not before Christian does what? He knocks. What's over the gate when he gets there? These words, knock, and it shall be opened unto you. That should recall the Sermon on the Mount. And another little poem here. He that will enter in must first without stand knocking at the gate, nor need he doubt. That is a knocker, but to enter in, for God can love him and forgive his sin. Knock therefore more than once or twice. That's scriptural. Keep on knocking. Saying, may I now enter here? Will he within open the sorry me, though I have been an undeserving rebel? Then shall I not fail to sing his lasting praises on high. That's Bunyan's advice as to how we come to Christ, is as an undeserving rebel. Not a worldly wise man. Not someone who's trusting in their own righteousness or their own good, but someone who says, I don't have any good to bring to you. So Goodwill reaches out, brings him in through the wicket gate, and he's now through it, but his burden is still on his back. The next time we gather, he's going to be on his way to interpreters, house of interpreter. And it's really interesting because this burden remains.